أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فمن حاجك فيه من بعد ما جاءك من العلم فقل تعالوا ندعو أبناءنا وأبناءكم ونساءنا ونساءكم وأنفسنا وأنفسكم ثم نبتهل فنجعل لعنة الله على الكاذبين. And if anyone should argue with thee about this truth after all the knowledge that has come unto thee, say, Come, let us summon our sons and your sons and our women and your women and ourselves and yourselves, and then let us pray together humbly and ardently, and let us invoke God's curse upon those of us who are telling a lie. Verse number 61. And if anyone should argue with you about this truth after all the knowledge that has come unto you, say, Come, let us summon our sons, let us call our sons and your sons and our women and your women and ourselves and yourselves, and then let us pray together unpretentiously and fervently, and let us appeal God's curse upon those of us who are telling a lie. Explanation 48, i.e. regarding the true nature of Jesus, according to all the reliable authorities, reliable scholars, verses 59 to 63 of this surah, Ali Imran, were sent in the year 10 after Hijrah on the occasion of a dispute between the Prophet and a deputation of the Christians of Najran, a group of people. They are Christians. They visited Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Like all other Christians, maintained that, they claimed that, they stated that, Jesus was the Son of God. According to Christians, Christians are sons of God, but Jesus is the Son of God. And they mean he was the special one. And therefore, God incarnate. Although they refused the trial through prayer, mubahala, proposed to them by the Prophet, the latter accorded to them a treaty guaranteeing all their civic rights and the free exercise of their religion. Islam doesn't prohibit other religions. Owners of other religions can practice their religions in Muslim society. Verse number 62.
إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْقَصَصُ الْحَقُّ وَمَا مِنْ إِلَهٍ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ.
Behold, this is indeed the truth of the matter, and there is no deity whatever save God, and verily God, He alone is almighty, truly wise. Behold, look, this is really the truth of the matter, and there is no God but only Allah, and indeed God, He alone is almighty, He can do whatever He wants. Truly wise, the wisdom belongs to Allah.
Verse number 63. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِالْمُفْسِدِينَ.
And if they turn away from this truth, behold, God has full knowledge of the spreaders of corruption. If they refuse Islam, see that God has full knowledge of the spreaders of the corruption. Who corrupts the religion, who corrupts the society. Allah sees whatever they think and whatever they do.
Verse number 64. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَقُولُوا اشْهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ.
say, O followers of earlier revelation, come unto that tenet which we and you hold in common, that we shall worship none but God, and that we shall not ascribe divinity to aught beside him, and that we shall not take human beings for our lords beside God, and if they turn away, then say, bear witness that it is we who have surrendered ourselves unto him. Say, O followers of earlier revelation, so they are Jewish people and Christians, but in Medina, lots of them were Jewish people. Come unto that tenet, come unto that belief, which we and you accept in general, that we shall worship none but Allah, only we worship Allah, and that we shall not ascribe divinity to nothing by Allah. Allah is alone, and we only worship him, and that we shall not take human beings for our lords. We don't accept other people as lords, but our Lord is Allah. And if they turn away, if they refuse, then say, bear witness that, see that, accept that it is we who have surrendered, who have given in ourselves unto Allah. Verse number 65.
يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَ تُحَاجُّونَ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَتِ التَّوْرَاةُ وَالْإِنْجِيلُ وَمَا أُنْزِلَتِ التَّوْرَاةُ وَالْإِنْجِيلُ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ.
O followers of earlier revelation, why do you argue about Abraham, seeing that the Torah and the Gospel were not revealed till long after him? Will you not then use your reason? Sorry, I have forgotten to explain what Muhammad Esed says in the explanation 49 and 50. Explanation 49, literally, a word that is equitable between you and us. So it is a word that we accept altogether, Muslims and non-Muslims, especially Ahl al-Kitab. The term kalima, word, primarily meaning word or utterance, is often used in the philosophical sense of proposition or tenet. Tenet means belief. Explanation 50, literally, that we shall not take one another for lords beside God, since the personal pronoun we obviously, clearly, applies to human beings, and the expression one another necessarily bears the same connotation, same intention. In its wider implication, in its wider meaning, the above call is addressed not only to the Christians who attribute divinity to Jesus, they consider Jesus as God as well, and certain aspects of divinity to their saints. Religious higher in rank, they consider, but also to the Jews who assign a quasi-divine authority to Ezra, in the Quran Uzair, this person, and even to some of their great Talmudic scholars. Now we can explain the explanation of 65, verse 65, and the explanation number is 51, i.e. as to whether the principles he followed were those of the Jewish faith, according to which the Torah is considered to be the final law of God, or of the Christian faith, which conflicts with the former, the previous one, in many respects. Verse number 66.
ها أنتم هؤلاء حاججتم فيما لكم به علم فلم تحاجون فيما ليس لكم به علم والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون.
Lo, you are the ones who would argue about that which is known to you, but why do you argue about something which is unknown to you? Yet God knows it, whereas you don't know. Look, you are the people who would argue, claim about that which is known to you, which you know, But why do you argue about something which is unknown to you? Gayb in Arabic. They don't know really. They can't know really, but they claim. Yet God knows it. God knows everything, whereas you don't know. There is an explanation here, 52. I.e., as to what was the true creed of Abraham, related to what was the true, real creed of, real belief of Abraham, that which is known to you is an allusion, is an indirect reference to their knowledge of the obvious fact, clear fact, that many of the teachings based on the existing versions of the Torah and the Gospels conflict. They are opposite to each other, conflict with the teachings of the Quran. Their teachings is opposite the Quran, Razi claims. Verse number 67.
ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين.
Abraham was neither a Jew nor a Christian, but was one who turned away from all that is false, having surrendered himself unto God, and he was not of those who ascribe divinity to aught beside him. Abraham wasn't a Jewish person, and he wasn't a Christian either, but Abraham was one who turned away from all that is false. He followed the truth. Having surrendered himself unto God, he was obeying Allah, and he didn't accept any deity except Allah. And he was not of those who ascribe, who accept divinity to aught beside him. He only worshipped Allah. Verse number 68.
Inna awla an-nasi bi Ibrahim lil-ladhina ittaba'uhu wa hadha an-nabiyyu wal-ladhina amanu wallahu waliyyul mu'minin.
Behold, the people who have the best claim to Abraham are surely those who follow him, as does this prophet and all who believe in him. And God is near unto the believers. Look, the people who have the best claim to Abraham are surely those who follow him, who obey him, as does this prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him, and all who believe, all Muslims, and God is near, close unto the believers. Verse number 69.
وَدَّتْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَوْ يُضِلُّونَكُمْ وَمَا يُضِلُّونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ.
Some of the followers of earlier revelation would love to lead you astray. Yet none do they lead astray but themselves and perceive it not. Some of the followers of earlier revelation would love to lead you away from what is proper. Yet none of them lead astray but themselves. They deceive themselves, not Muslims in reality, but they can't understand that. Verse number 70.
يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَأَنْتُمْ تَشْهَدُونَ.
O followers of earlier revelation, why do you deny the truth of God's messages to which you yourselves bear witness? Ehl al-Kitab, Allah addresses them. Why do you deny, why do you not accept the truth of God's messages, the Quran, to which you yourselves bear witness? Although you see that he is a prophet and the Quran comes from Allah, why don't you accept it? Explanation 53. Literally, when you yourselves bear witness, an allusion, indirect reference to the biblical prophecies, biblical revelations relating to the coming of the Prophet Muhammad. So he means that there were some verses in the Bible related to Prophet Muhammad, related to his coming and the Quran, but they deleted it and they hid those verses because they didn't want to accept the last prophet. Verse number 71.
يا أهل الكتاب لم تلبسون الحق بالباطل وتكتبون الحق وأنتم تعلمون.
O followers of earlier revelation, why do you cloak the truth with falsehood and conceal the truth of which you are so well aware? O followers of earlier revelation, Ahl al-Kitab, why do you cloak the truth? Why do you curtain, mask the truth which falsehood and conceal, hide the truth of which you are so well aware, you know it so well?
Verse number 72. وقالت طائفة من أهل الكتاب آمنوا بالذي أنزل على الذين آمنوا وجه النهار واكفروا آخرة لعلهم يرجعون.
And some of the followers of earlier revelation to say to one another, declare your belief in what has been revealed unto those who believe in Muhammad at the beginning of the day, and deny the truth of what came later, so that they might go back on their faith. And some of the Christians and Jewish people, they say, declare your belief, say that you are a Muslim, in what has been revealed unto those who believe in Muhammad at the beginning of the day. In the morning, say you believe, and refuse the truth of what came later, so that they might go back on their faith. Try to influence Muslims. Sometimes you believe, sometimes you disbelieve. Because of that, they will have some faith problems in their minds, and they will refuse Islam. Muslims will leave Islam. They think so. The people of the book. Explanation 54. Most of the commentators, relying on, depending on views current available among some of the Tabi'un, i.e. the generation that come after the companions of the Prophet, companions, Sahaba in Arabic, understand this passage thus. Declare at the beginning of the day your belief in what has been revealed unto those sent unto those who believe in Muhammad, and deny, refuse the truth thereof in its latter part. This rendering, this meaning would imply that the Judeo-Christian attempts at confusing the Muslims, Muslim mind, to which the above verse refers, consisted in alternatingly declaring belief and disbelief in the Quranic message. On the other hand, the rendering accepted by me, by Muhammad Asad, and supported by Al-Asam, as far as I know, Al-Asam, one of the Mu'tazilite Quran exegetes, whose interpretation has been quoted by Razi in Mafatihul Ghaib, in his commentary on this verse, implies that some Jews and Christians have been and are hoping to achieve, to be successful, this end by admitting, accepting, however reluctantly, unwillingly, that there may be some truth in the early Quranic revelations, that which has been revealed at the beginning of the day, while they categorically reject its later parts, in as much as to the degree that they clearly contradict, negate, oppose certain biblical teachings. As far as I understand, Muhammad Asad gives another meaning by considering the interpretation of Al-Asam available in Razi's Quran exegesis. In the first part of the Quran, when Quran was revealed, the first Quranic verses were accepted by the people of the book, but later parts they refused them because they wanted to divert Muslim mind from the Quran and They wanted Muslims to leave Islam. Verse number 73.
وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا إِلَّا مَنْ تَبِعَ دِينَكُمْ قُلْ إِنَّ الْهُدَى هُدَى اللَّهِ أَنْ يُؤْتَى أَحَدٌ مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيتُمْ أَوْ يُحَاجُّوكُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ قُلْ إِنَّ الْفَضْلَ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ
But don't really, do not really believe anyone who does not follow your own faith. Say, behold, all true guidance is God's guidance, consisting in once being granted revelation, such as you have been granted. Or would they contend against you before your sustainer? Say, behold, all bounty is in the hand of God. He grants it unto whom he wills. For God is infinite, all-knowing. And some of the followers of the earlier revelation, people of the book, say to one another, each other, declare your belief in what has been revealed. This was verse 73. But don't really believe anyone who does not follow your own faith. Only believe your book and don't accept the latest prophet and the book sent to him. Say, behold, say, look, all true guidance is God's guidance, the Quran, consisting in once being granted revelation, such as you have been granted, or would they contend against you before your sustainer, before your maintainer? Say, behold, all bounty is the hand of God. Allah has everything, and whoever he wants, he gives, he grants. He grants it unto whom he wills. People can't decide which one will be the prophet, which book will be sent. Allah decides. For God is infinite, limitless, all-knowing. Explanation 55. This refers to the Jews and Christians who are not prepared to accept the Quranic message on the ground that as it conflicts with parts of their own scriptures. Quran criticizes some beliefs and practices of the people of the book. So by considering that, some of the people of the book oppose the Quran. Explanation 56. In this context, the term fadl, bounty, benevolence, is synonymous with the bestowal of divine revelation, the Quran. Verse number 74.
يَخْتَصُّ بِرَحْمَتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ
Singling out for his grace whom he wills, and God is limitless in his great bounty. Allah will decide who he will give his book, divine inspiration, and he is limitless in his great bounty, great mercy.
Ve ahiru da'wana enilhamdülillahi rabbil alemin.